Ying Vision.
Dropped on my face, basically. I was getting beat around.
I had a panic attack right away, my first one ever.
You have to prepare for the worst case scenario.
It kind of felt like foam crushing. Whitewater kayaking, canoeing, rock climbing, ice climbing, caving with and without ropes, backcountry skiing, cross-country skiing, snowshoeing, mountain biking, backpacking.
Rock climbing is my thing.
I do rock, ice climbing, winter mountaineering, and mountaineering in general.
I'm really into rock climbing.
We're going to go to Maine. It was going to be fun.
It was going to be awesome.
And then this dumbass dislocates his shoulder.
Yeah, it was like four or five days before we were going to go, and I dislocated my shoulder. I went in, like, dropped on my face, basically, and was getting beat around and popped my shoulder out, and I could feel it. It kind of felt like foam crushing, just kind of like that. Roll it up. But anyway, so I got surgery for a little while ago, and you can see one hole there, one there, there's another one in the back.
So the outing club activities are way more hardcore than I think a lot of us are used to joining the club. First when I came in, I thought it was like the easiest thing to do, you know, I thought we'd be walking through caverns, but it was like crawling on your toes and elbows, and I had a panic attack right away, my first one ever, because it's really tight spaces, but you kind of feel kind of closer to the earth, literally, but also it's a different feeling, and you just trust the earth differently, I guess, the rock.
I don't know, it's funny because like I'm a really clumsy person when I'm walking around on ground, but like when I start climbing on rocks and, you know, holding onto little tiny things and being able to climb straight up, it's completely different. I've seen other people who are like really, really clumsy too, and they're able to just climb super gracefully.
Like rock climbing, for example, like it's, you can't learn on your own, you know, you need someone to teach you. And there's like very few places, like you have to spend a lot of money or spend a lot of time looking for people who are here. Like, you can like know nothing about it and just sign up and go and learn a lot.
And it's fun to learn new things, of course, with definitely learning with other people creates a new kind of bond.
For sure, because they're pretty much like my family, even though I didn't really know that many people in the club still when I came back 4 years later. It was like this instant bond with everybody because, like I said, everyone is just like this big, huge, really close-knit family, which is really, really cool. That's one of the things that really drew me to hang out with the outing club.
Cool. You wouldn't believe, these guys will walk around here and you would never believe who and what they are and what they do. What they are. If you ever get into what they've actually done and you start talking about what they've done in the sport or the field or that type of thing, you'll be in a state of disbelief.
It's like being able to escape, especially in Syracuse. It's really nice to be able to get out of the city and out into the woods and not really think about schoolwork for a while or anything like that.
And like, we came, we saw, and we climbed.
Get wet, get dirty, get high, get out. And that was SUOC.
What's impossible, they forgot. This world keeps spinning, and with each new day.